We all know that we should recycle plastic products, but unlike glass and aluminum, plastics are not infinitely recyclable. When plastic materials are processed or recycled, their molecular bonds can break, causing the material's fundamental properties to weaken. One way plastics can be made more sustainable is by using self-assembled soft materials. These self-assembled soft materials can reform their molecular connections after being damaged. Scientists are exploring how these self-healing properties can be used in nanotechnology and biomedical applications, but their molecular scale behavior is not very well understood. The O'Connor Lab in the Department of Materials Science and Engineering at Carnegie Mellon University is working to change that by studying associating polymer networks, a type of self-assembling polymer material. These polymers are made of long molecular chains that contain sticky groups along their lengths. The sticky groups clump together into clusters of different sizes. These clusters connect the chains into a network. To understand how associating polymers will behave during manufacturing, O'Connor simulated their behavior during elongational deformation. He found that elongation caused the polymers to behave in two very different ways. Chains that were stuck to weak clusters easily broke free and stretched out a lot, but chains stuck to bigger clusters couldn't break free and were unable to elongate. This heterogeneous response of the polymer molecules helps explain why self-assembled materials are so unpredictable during manufacturing. However, unexpectedly, when O'Connor simulated faster deformation, all the chains began stretching out uniformly like they would in a normal polymer. This happened because the strong flow was able to break up clusters of all sizes, and they all began to take on similar shapes and sizes throughout the material. This showed the researchers that all hope is not lost for working with, processing, and one day recycling self-assembled polymer materials.